What's up, guys? My name is Aaron Neiman.
And I'm Mika Fads.
And welcome to the first ever episode of
Gamers Paradise.
Nailed it.
I like this.
Nailed it.
I have a good feeling. I have a good feeling.
First take,
100%
no
organic.
Off the cuff.
Believe it.
That's great. So, a little bit about the show, Mika.
Well, all of the juiciest gaming content that you have been looking for, look no further. It is right here on
Gamers Paradise. I almost fell.
Two for two.
But I caught up.
I was like half a second there, but I caught it.
Two for two. So, a little bit about this as well is this is a place where you can get competitive.
I like that.
Get competitive. That's what we're about. Showcase your hidden talents.
Ooh, I like that too.
That's going to be
good.
Better
be prepared.
And of course, if this is a place you simply want to hang out, well, this is the place for you. Also, if you like the way that sounds, grab your snacks, take off your socks. We're about to get started. We've got pro players throwing hands over hotcakes, exclusive interviews.
I love hotcakes. Can I just say, like, the whole hotcakes versus waffles thing?
Breakfast.
Maple syrup, peanut butter,
butter
whipped cream,
butter,
chocolate chips,
you make a sandwich.
blueberries.
Very nice. Very cool. Hard to find.
Yeah, but very good.
Everything
on it.
Mika, sorry, I meant hot takes. Sorry, hot that was my mistake.
That makes a lot more sense.
That does make sense. Hotcakes aside, our guest, MPL Shoutcasters, Leo Cass and Umi, will be throwing hands over hot takes on the Pulse.
But you know what else is important, guys? Knowing how our most admired professional gamers and esports personalities made it to the top of the industry. In fact, you guys are in for a treat because we're sitting down for a segment we call Hero Story with renowned host and TV correspondent, and I'm fangirling here actually, Mara Aquino, who's got some words of wisdom that she wants to share.
That's right. And also, so this is a place where we got some friends and guests that we can hang out with every episode. But before we get down and dirty with the particulars of gaming, we're going to highlight the Paradise part of our show as a cool down. From all those spicy moments from The Pulse, we're going to take you around incredible cities around Asia from our own buddies from the gaming community. Today in particular, we'll be experiencing the soothing vacation breeze with Indonesian caster Momo-chan on Gamer's Haven.
This is me enjoying the breeze.
Yes, another word for breeze is zephyr.
Ooh.
Yes.
Today I learned.
That's right. Yeah. But for the fun, it doesn't end there. You'll have to stick around until the end of the episode for an exclusive We Fought For This.
I know. I'm so excited.
We fought for this.
I'm so excited.
We really did. We really wanted this. This is where everyone can get together, get competitive, and maybe showcase their hidden talents in a little games we kind of come up with for House Party.
Yes.
Excited for that.
There it is again. There it is again. So you guys probably figured out which game we're tackling today based on familiar faces that we mentioned. That is right. For our first Gamers Paradise episode, we will be covering one of the fastest rising titles in Southeast Asia, Mobile Legends Bang Bang.
Very cool. Do you play?
Yes,
nice.
I do. I am actually mythic in Mobile Legends. I'm a mid laner.
Nice.
Yeah.
I have finished the tutorial.
Really?
Yes.
You are officially the first person I know that has finished the tutorial.
I commit.
Actually, why don't we head on over for a special discussion on The Pulse?
Why are you pushing me?
You're supposed to.
Oh, I have to walk over to the other set.
It's on the other side.
I got it. My man.
It's a big place.
Get started.
All right. Sorry, guys, just a little bit out of breath. I gotta get used to that. Thank you so much, Mika. I can feel some tension here already. I like it. Ladies and gentlemen, as Mika mentioned, in this part of the show, we'll have two guests ready to duke it out over the hottest questions in the gaming sphere. For instance, console or PC? Who is the greatest esports player of all time?
Not Leo.
Either better with hair? What do I look like? Who wrote that?
He did.
Huh? You. Okay, moving forward, ladies and gentlemen, these are just some of the things that we might get an answer for on The Pulse. Yes. For the pilot episode, we are going to be discussing, ladies and gentlemen, what is the best kind of roamer for MLBB? This is the person that this is the kind of player, the kind of roamer that just leads to win. Their decisions just more in the grand scheme of things wins more games. So ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce two prolific casters in the MLBB scene. To my left, ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause to Leo!
At your service, how's everybody doing?
Thank you. And to my right, ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause from the campus sports scene, esports scene, to hear Umi!
Thank you so much for having me here.
I love the hostility. So ladies and gentlemen, that is what we're going to be talking about. The floor is open.
And since you have lower points than me in the game, you first.
Disrespect starts early. All right. Are you going to take that?
As it has been in the league, I came first, so I will start first.
All right.
Let me school you. Uomi has never played Rome in the history of working in the league and playing with him for years now. He has never played Rome. You correct?
I literally played Rome Cho back there backstage, man.
That doesn't count. Like
he's essentially saying you know nothing about this discussion. Leo, open the floor. Here
I have casted the game for years. I have played the game for years, and I played all the roles, right?
Yes. Uh-huh.
I'd like to start by saying the best kind of roamer is a roamer that I need an initiator. I need someone who is willing to put themselves on the line, and say, you know what? Here's who we're getting. Here's what we're doing this way.
This way. Someone who's a doer, action, an initiator.
Exactly. Eric gets it, bro.
You know, it's a 5v5 game. So I think being a doer without actually considering or thinking about your teammates is a dumb way to die in the game.
Just called you dumb.
So the doer type of thing, sometimes it does work, especially if you're looking at amateur games. But if you're looking at professional games, let's take example like Light from RSG Philippines.
Yeah,
Champions of MPL Season 9. Perhaps
season
the
nine.
Best roamer right now in the current meta. There's a reason why he's the best. It's because he's smart. He knows when to go in and not to go for the plays that usually the doers do immediately.
Marcus, don't put words in my mouth.
Called you Marcus.
And here's the thing. Light was once my player, all right?
Okay, sure.
And homie would not be where he is right now. Light would not be a champion. Light would not be a season MVP if he did not start in the amateur season.
Wait a minute. When he was your player, there were eighth place. And when Coach Panda got your player.
Nay.
Oh, wait. You know what? Season 7, you're right.
Correct. That was our rookie season, and we finished 5-6.
Dude, that's still significantly lower than when Coach Panda took over your role and made Light into a champion. So I'm sorry, Leo. You can't take credit for that.
Coming from one who has not yet coached in the MPL.
Oh, wow. You weren't even a coach,
that
dude.
Was below the belt. Oh, my God. I can't even.
All right.
You were just an analyst.
So, ladies and gentlemen, to end this discussion, you are going from an initiator, someone who does, you, someone who thinks and, of course, assesses the situation and makes the right play.
Wait.
Final close.
Coming from just an analyst to coach, I actually had my time in competitive play. So, I don't know what this guy's talking about.
He's saying you ain't no pro.
I'm a doer. Yeah, I'm a doer.
He's saying you ain't no pro. That's what he's saying.
Ask SD, ask Bentings, ask Light. I'll have my resume speak for itself.
Sure.
Oh my God. This is a battle of experience and credentials, ladies and gentlemen. It got personal. But thank you very much, Umi and Leo. I'm glad that we stopped before it got violent. It was getting hot. Ladies and gentlemen, you got your first taste of The Pulse. We love it. And ladies and gentlemen, what is your opinion? What is the best thing a roamer can do? Which of these two actually have better experience in that regard? Let us know. We'd love to hear your feedback. That was hot. Speaking of hot, we're going to be talking to one of the legendary esports hosts in our next segment. In the meantime, Gamers Paradise, we'll be back right after quick.
You're hot without hair.
You're hot.
I'm married.
What we agree on. You're hot.
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
I appreciate that. That's something we get on
the
same
page. I'm married. Aaron Neiman is hot.
Okay, stop. Let's keep going.
We are not here on this planet to close our eyes to the world. We are here to go out and experience its many wonders. Because through our experiences, we become bigger than ourselves. Travel has the power to shape our world and make us whole again. With 30 hotel brands and endless experiences, where can we take you?
we don't have.
I mean,
there you guys are. Welcome back to Gamers Paradise. What did you think about the first edition of The Pulse?
I mean, I didn't know that there was so much drama with Umi and Leo. It was like, wow.
It was beautiful. Wow. It was beautiful to see them go at it like that. But yeah, that was spicy.
But
that was,
I think we have to steer the show away from the drama right now. We have to switch it up a notch and meet someone who's been making waves in the MLBB scene. And actually, even in the sports scene, talk about crossovers. Mm. We can actually talk about crossovers, but that's just me being misdirected once again. Time to meet our heroes and hear about what it's like being in the professional ring in Hero Story.
Like my lovely co-host mentioned, this segment takes a deep dive into the story of your favorite gaming and esports personalities. And we are very much looking forward to our first guest for this episode. Mika, why don't you take it away?
I do want to do the honors for this. Let's please welcome over to Hero Story, Ms. Mara Aquino, content creator extraordinaire and TV host. She's one of my idols.
Oh my God.
I'm like, I have been low-key fangirling all day, okay? Kind of doing this.
Now we get to meet. Thank you for having me.
Thank you also for being here. She's been one of my idols. She is amazing. Her journey has started in sports. It's mind-boggling to me, actually. It's really amazing.
Speaking of what Mika just said, so you started in sports, Mara, right? And then you transitioned into esports. How was that transition for you? Like, from sports to esports?
First of all, it was really hard just because Mobile Legends is my first MOBA game. Mm. And the opportunity just presented itself. During the pandemic, sports is put on hold.
Yes.
So I had no job. And then around June 2020, I discovered Mobile Legends. Mm. I was playing like 36 hours a day till my back hurt.
That's hardcore.
And then I noticed MPL, it was still going. And I thought, oh my gosh, it would be so nice if I get to host that. I visualized it.
Manifested it.
It started with an idea. And then a few months later, I got a call to host it.
Really?
So that's how it started.
Oh my God, that's some high level manifesting.
I know.
That is
high
level manifesting.
You really gotta teach me how to do that.
Yeah, can you teach me? Can you do a seminar about that kind of thing? We'd love to kind of
really
know.
I've been really lucky. Universe, thank you.
Very cool.
You know what? You're so amazing. You know your work on the MPL. It's so wonderful how you get esports players to open up to you and really like you know bare their hearts and their souls to you. How do you do that? Especially since esports players, they can be very shy.
That's true.
Oh, yeah. Well, first, I try to make them comfortable. So I try to be relatable. I pay attention to everything. I pay attention to what they're saying, what they're doing. So sometimes I look at the game and I try to ask something that the commentators cannot answer. Mm-hmm. How are they feeling? What are they thinking? If I notice something, a certain reaction, I will ask about that. Mm. And basically, what I do is when I'm talking to them, I try to relate to them. I try to reword and I take us back. Take us back through this moment. Mm. You must be feeling this way. Mm. Describe this feeling. So I get their thoughts and their feelings. And basically, I try to make sure that they know I understand them. Mm. When they're comfortable, they open up more.
Mm. Yeah.
Do you have a particular interview where you felt you were able to do that the best possible way? Is there an interview that pops out?
That would probably be the most emotional interview would be Blacklist International.
Mm.
There was a time that basically they won against RSG and it was a really important game, but they weren't celebrating. Mm. And I asked questions that nobody dared to ask. Mm-hmm. I asked them, I would imagine that you would have been happy jumping, but why were you not celebrating? Is there an issue? And then it was Edward during that time, and he slowly opened up. I was asking things that I know the viewers wanted to know.
Mm.
And I tried to trigger certain emotions for them to open up.
That's actually one of the interviews that like I definitely thought, oh my gosh, she's one of the best in the industry, because not everybody can do that. What's actually your advice for, you know, for people who might want to get into esports, maybe do something similar to your role? What would be your advice for aspiring talents out there?
First, you have to be able to visualize, just like what I said earlier, visualize. If you can picture yourself doing it, you're there.
Okay.
You're there already. So what I do when I'm on the couch, I I know what I'm going to get myself into, and I know this is my area. Know what you want. What is your goal? What is your North Star? And never forget it. Number one mistake people make is that they start something, and then when hardships come, they forget why they started in the first place. And one thing to keep yourself in check, I always tell people also, assign about 3 people in your life who you respect in that category. So whether that's love life, that's career, and those 3 people will keep you in check. So when is your head getting too big? Are you changing? Are you not yourself anymore? Is there something that you need to do to improve? If those 3 people say the same thing, then that must mean that you need to change.
True.
You need credible people who you respect, who know that industry, who know what they're saying, and you listen to those 3 people, not the 1,000 voices or 100 voices on social media.
Yes, of course.
Otherwise, you will get drowned.
Exactly, exactly. Oh my gosh. Mara, thank you so much for joining us here on Hear a Story. I feel like I want to sign up for a seminar with you.
Oh my gosh.
We need to manifest together, girl.
Yes.
We need to.
Law of attraction.
Yes, we do.
But there you have it. Mara, thank you so much.
That was
very, very helpful for anyone who's aspiring to go on the same path as a host. And we appreciate your time with us, and we hope you can come back again in the future to guest again.
Invite me anytime.
There you go. There you go. So, ladies and gentlemen, Mara Acuna, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. So, coming up, we are going to take a little scenic view to the land of the gods. All that and more coming up next.
We are not here on this planet to close our eyes to the world. We are here to go out and experience its many wonders. Because through our experiences, we become bigger than ourselves. Travel has the power to shape our world and make us whole again. With 30 hotel brands and endless experiences, where can we take you?
Little slice of coded heaven on earth. This is Gamers Paradise.
4 for 4.
By gamers, for gamers. Today we're getting up close and personal with Indonesian MPL caster Momo Chan. So not only is this lady a boss shoutcaster, she's also a content creator and an ambassador for a number of brands in her home country.
And today she's giving us a tour of the Ultra Lux Hotel W Bali.
Halo semuanya, kenalin aku Momo Chan. Aku seorang content creator, influencer, streamer, dan juga seorang caster untuk game Mobile Legends. Jadi perjalanan aku di dunia game itu dimulai pada tahun 2016. Jadi awalnya itu aku punya kenalan, teman aku kerja di event organizer. Dan di situ dia nawarin, Momo Chan mau coba jadi caster nggak? Terus pertama kali aku nggak tahu caster itu apa kan. Dan pada saat itu tuh aku lagi seneng-senengnya belajar hal baru. Game favorit aku sekarang udah pasti Mobile Legends, dan yang bikin aku suka itu adalah bisa mabar sama teman-teman. Gak cuma sama teman-teman yang aku kenal, kadang sama fans-fans juga yang sering nontonin aku di live streaming, atau mungkin sama pro player juga kan. Kadang aku suka SKSD gitu minta digendong. Nah, itu serunya sih main Mobile Legends, bisa main sama teman-teman. Hero pertama yang aku coba itu Tigreal. Itu aku inget banget masih OP waktu 2017. Terus habis itu aku mulai main hero-hero lain seperti Grok, terus ada Cho juga. Tapi yang jadi favorit aku sih sekarang Grok sih. Terus udah gitu menurut aku aku suka main yang apa ya, jadi hero tuh yang paling depan terus gitu loh. Dan aku kan nggak pinter apa ya, nggak pinter carry gamenya. Aku cuma pinter tahan badan. Jadi bisa dibilang ya tank itu jadi salah satu favorit role aku sekarang. Yang aku suka dari e-sport tuh sebenarnya kalau di e-sport ya kita bisa kenalan sama orang-orang baru, terus ketemu sama klien baru juga, ketemu sama fans juga, ketemu sama penggiat-penggiat e-sport juga. Jadi yang benar-benar pengen terjun ke dunia e-sport, pengen belajar, mereka tuh biasanya datang ke event-event. Nah, kita tuh biasa kenalan sama mereka di sana. Plus, sekarang e-sport tuh juga didukung sama pemerintah. Jadi aku benar-benar kayak merasakan kayak ya pekerjaan aku adalah hobi aku. Jadi aku merasa ini fun banget. Yang bikin aku seneng di kerjaan ini ya sebenarnya ini karena part of hobi ya. Jadi sebagian dari hobi aku juga. Dan dari kecil kan, dari SD aku udah suka nge-game sampai sekarang. Dan akhirnya ya senang bisa terjun ke e-sport karena ya ini bagian dari apa yang aku suka. Aku jalanin apa yang aku suka, aku lakuin apa yang aku suka. Jadi kesannya fun aja, menyenangkan. Kalau traveling yang biasanya aku cari itu sightseeing sih. Jadi aku lebih suka ngeliat pemandangan, lebih suka ke pantai, ke laut. Aku nggak suka yang kayak terlalu apa ya, mungkin terlalu murah tenaga ya, kayak main banana boat atau mungkin yang kayak apa paragliding. Mungkin karena aku takut nyemplung juga kali. Tapi aku suka sih, kayak maksudnya kayak ngeliat pemandangan aja aku udah seneng gitu, kayak lihat air biru, pantai, itu bagus. Jadi aku lebih suka sightseeing daripada aktivitas-aktivitas berat.
Hayo, teman-teman pasti pada penasaran kan? Pada kepo kan kira-kira aku bawa apa aja ya di dalam tas aku selama aku traveling? Tadaaa! Jadi aku bakalan kasih lihat ke teman-teman nih, kira-kira barang-barang penting apa aja yang aku bawa selama aku traveling. Sebenarnya nggak banyak sih, jadi aku tuh bawa yang penting-penting aja ya, kayak nih handphone daily, ini biasa aku bawa. Terus ada handphone gaming juga, karena aku pisahin ya handphone gaming sama handphone daily use aku. Terus ada wallet juga, ini ada dompet, di sini ini si kartu, ada kartu identitas, kartu-kartu yang lain, ada duit juga buat jajan. Terus ada hand sanitizer, juga ini penting banget ya buat lap tangan kalau di mana-mana tempat umum. Terus udah gitu ada make up nih, yang aku bilang nih ada make up. Ini penting banget sih menurut aku karena bisa dibilang ya, kok make upnya hilang? Oh ini ada satu di sini ternyata ya. Nah jadi ini aku bawa bedak sama bawa lip tint. Menurut aku sih yang paling penting tuh lip tint ya. Bedak nih aku jarang banget sih bawa. Tapi lip tint ini paling penting guys karena harus tetap fresh ya dari muka. Terus ada earphone juga. Kalau aku bosen dengerin musik tuh biasa aku bawa earphone. Nah juga ada kunci rumah, karena kalau nggak ada kunci rumah kan nggak bisa masuk. Nah kira-kira ini doang nih guys barang-barang yang aku bawa selama traveling.
Aku kasih buat teman-teman yang mungkin pengen jadi gaming content creator ya, itu tetap berusaha, tetap semangat, karena semua orang itu kan mulai dari nol ya, nggak ada yang langsung instan, semuanya ada prosesnya. Dan aku pun di dunia e-sport itu udah berapa tahun, berarti dari 2016 sampai sekarang udah 6 hampir 7 tahun lah. Jadi memang semuanya ada proses dan itu nggak instan gitu. Jadi tetap lakuin apa yang kamu suka, apa yang jadi hobi kamu, tetap komitmen, konsisten, karena konsisten tuh penting menurut aku. Jadi tetap berusaha.
Thanks for showing us around, Momo-chan. Oh,
beautiful.
Can't wait to go back.
Yeah.
Please, I want to go back. Everything is so beautiful and I'm just about ready to book my flight.
You should book one.
I actually, now.
They have a promo.
Oh.
Okay, now she left. Okay. You didn't think the fun was over yet, did you? Because we've got one more segment, and I'd like to think we saved the best for last. Get those tabs ready. I can already imagine all the clips we'll have to look back on after today's house party.
For our first episode, we call this game Silence. You're supposed to work with me. I will be saying some words, or it could be a phrase, and you have to try and guess what I'm trying to say. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, please put on your noise-canceling earphones.
Win this. All
win
right.
this.
Ari,
let's go.
There's no
you're going
same,
down.
Same team.
Mika.
Same team.
Going down.
Same team. All
Here
right.
Here we go.
Just
we go.
Checking. Can you guys hear me? Can you guys hear what I'm saying? Yeah? Uomi? Uomi, can you hear what I'm saying?
I can't hear you.
Can you hear what I'm saying? It makes it sound like you can hear me, but all right, all right. Round number one.
Game of the game.
Yes, oh, yes.
Okay, okay.
Yes, okay. Esmeralda. Esmeralda.
I got
okay.
this.
Esmeralda.
Okay. Iceburger lang.
We got this.
Iceburger lang.
We got this.
I believe one more.
I can't
Ice
hear you.
Burger lang.
We got this.
Huh? Isa pa.
We got
Ice
this.
Iceburger lang.
Okay. I'll try.
Bro, you gotta
we got
get this,
this
right.
Come on, Leo. Yeah, focus. Back. Focus. Let's win. Let's win. Let's win.
Esmeralda.
Yes.
Esmeralda.
Yes.
Can you do it slower Let's with bigger mouth?
Esmeralda.
Ah, we got
easy,
this.
Easy.
I got you. I got it.
Esmeralda.
Say it again. Say it one more time. Say it one more time.
Esmeralda.
One more time, just to be sure. One more time.
Esmeralda.
I'm looking at. I'm looking. I hear it.
Da.
You oh, going yeah. down, Mika? You're going down.
Not,
we got this.
Not,
we win this
we're
round.
We're on the same team.
We win this round.
We're on the same. All right.
Is it done?
All right. Remove your noise canceling earphones.
Okay.
Let's go.
Remove it. All right. What is the answer?
Let's go. For the win, first of all, good teamwork. We did well there.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mika.
I feel like it broke down here. It broke down here.
No, no. I feel like it broke down on Leo's
No,
part.
I got it. I got it. Esmeralda.
Oh my gosh.
Esmeralda. Esmeralda. That's what you said?
That's
oh
what
gosh.
I said. That's what I heard from him.
Is that what you heard?
That's what I said.
You're all Esmeralda?
We're all Esmeraldas.
Esmeralda.
Iceburger lang.
Iceburger?
What's an iceberg?
Iceburger lang?
I don't know. Does it have to make sense? That's what I. That's what he
is
said.
Is it lang? You put lang
but,
on the iceberger?
Yeah.
Like you just... you
that's
Iceburger
what he said.
Lang?
Okay, it's like amazing. You got, it's amazing that the right answer got to the end of the line despite the iceberger being in
wait.
The way.
So wait, do we get that point?
Yes.
Do we
you
get
guys,
that point?
There was an anomaly. Time we
get the point.
There so was
we
an
do.
Anomaly.
Ice, that was okay. Iceberg,
on,
it's okay. Iceberger was fine.
We're on the same blink. Team. All right, right.
That's
right.
What I'm talking about. When you focus, you got the rebound.
Focus,
that's
focus.
What we
Ari.
Do. That's what we do. 1-0.
We're
we are up.
Team.
We
to be-
are up, people.
Supposed to be hosting this.
Let's go.
Supposed to be hosting this. All right, word number two. Ready?
Amazing.
Ready. Okay. Enchanted talisman. Enchanted talisman.
I know it. Okay, okay.
Enchanted talisman.
Again.
Enchanted talisman.
One more, last.
Enchanted talisman.
It's so long. There's so many syllables. but it's one word. Mobile Legends.
That's so easy.
Mobile Legends.
I already know that. Mobile Legends.
Mobile Legends, bang, bang.
Mobile Legends, bang, bang. Easy. Easy. It's easy. It's the best game. You ready?
What?
You ready? Mobile Legends. Bang, bang.
Say it again.
Mobile.
Mobile.
Legends.
Legends.
Bang, bang.
I got you.
Mobile Legends. Bang, bang.
I got you. I got you.
It's too easy, right?
It's too easy.
All right.
You can do
all right.
it. Easy.
All right. Remove. All right. Remove the earphones. Okay. All right. All right. So you have the answer?
Mika, the first word was mobile. The second word was legends. And the last two words lead to your defeat, which is bang, bang.
Aww. All right.
Bang, bang. 2-0. Let's go.
Uomi said the same thing. Leo, did you hear that?
No, that's exactly what I said.
Did we do it?
No.
Mara?
I heard enchanted. I saw enchanted talisman.
What the?
You're right. Oh, diba? You're right.
Iceberg lang. Enchanted talisman.
How do you say?
You are correct.
No, she was right. But how do you say enchanted talisman with no lips?
Enchanted talisman.
She can say it without any lips.
Did you say enchant? Wait, what's the correct answer?
Enchanted talisman. She got it right.
Say it with no lips.
Enchanted talisman.
You got Mobile Legends Bang Bang from Enchanted talisman.
She wasn't losing her lips.
Say it to me.
Enchanted talisman.
That's enchanted talisman. That's enchanted talisman,
yeah,
Leo.
You have no earphones on.
Huh? I heard
it. Made us lose.
All right, that's about wraps up episode one. Thank you guys for being so willing to take part in our first episode, in our first segment of House Party. Thank you guys for watching. This is Mika Fabs.
And this has been Ari Neiman for the first episode of
Gamers Paradise. Good job, you guys. I thought it was like...
Well, rematch.
I was like,
rematch.
Yes. There's no... Can I be on rematch. The team now?
Yes, you can.
I can. It's fine.